So this is one of my favorite exercises. It's a multi-discipline exercise that develops a lot of accuracy within the rider. It helps the balance of the horse, and more importantly, it develops strength in the horse as well. So I set the poles out, and it's great and ideal for a small arena with a 16 meter span across. So it's quite small, but you don't necessarily have to start on the inside of the poles. We're working in trot here, and this is just showing you with a 6-year-old horse that's got a certain degree of balance, but struggling just to start with to come around the turn and stay straight. As we get into the exercise, the horse becomes a little bit more accustomed to following the aids of the rider, using the outside hind to push through and across the turn, and starts to develop a little bit more weight carrying capacity on the inside hind leg. So it's a great exercise for turning and holding. So you see here the rider is really making a positive turn with her upper body, and she's holding the wall of the aids of the outside to encourage the horse to stay within her boundaries of the outside aids, as well as being soft to the inside. It's a really good exercise to help develop the horse's suppleness and flexibility, and it really encourages the drop of the inside hind leg, the inside hip, as it goes around a turn. As I said, this is a multidiscipline exercise. We often would put a halter, specific marker, maybe a rein back, might walk for 4 or 5 steps at exactly the same place each time. So you make the rider very specific about where they ride to, so it doesn't allow them to get sloppy in their riding. And then we can use this exercise to make a few little gear changes. So we have Roz riding around the outside now, and as she comes out of the turn, she'll open the stride for a few strides past the poles, and then balance the stride just a little bit coming into the turn. So you're teaching the horse to come out of a turn and develop an open stride, and then balance the stride going into a turn, which is a really important thing to do. So if we think about the horse's hind leg and how we train it through the years, starting at the lower levels where we just train that hind leg to step through and go forward and take a forward step and think about tracking up. The next thing that's very important is we start to encourage the horse's hind leg to take a sideward step, a step underneath laterally, and this will encourage the inside hock to drop, the hips to drop, and the muscles to start to develop with that underneath sideways step. Then eventually we train the horse to start to weight carry a little bit more, so the hind leg steps even more through. The back really has a round feel to it, and the horse starts to become a little bit more lighter in front, so the turns become easier and we get that sort of light uphill feeling. So major points to be aware of: because this exercise might tire the horse, make sure you recognize if he does become fatigued and alter the exercise where need be to give his muscles time to relax. With your own aids, make sure your outside aids are fairly firm and you create a nice supporting wall on the outside, but at the same time your inside aids are fairly soft to allow the horse to bend around your inside leg. Because it does take quite a lot of effort from the horse, make sure you do praise and reward by giving him a breather every so often as he does start to become fatigued.